Hello my friends, and welcome back to episode 19 of my leveling guide of Fractured Online. In the last episode, we hunted the bandits down here and we discovered all the hotspots and collected dozens of knowledge points. It was really worth it. In this episode, we go hunting for goblins again. But this time we don't kill goblins that live on Mir, but I already announced it in the last episode, we travel to Erhen. To get to Erhen, which is the second continent of the game, we have to use the harbor. Look at your map and check where the nearest harbor is located for you. In my case, it's the harbor in the very south. The eastern harbor is also not far away, but I will use the southern harbor to travel to Erhen. Now the thing is that you have to pay a fee at the harbor, and that fee is actually quite high. There's always a base fee that varies depending on the distance. The fee ranges from 300 to 700 gold, at least that's the experience I've had. If you change continents, you have to add 1000 additional gold. In addition, the fee increases by 1% for every kilogram you carry. That means in my case the fee would increase by 34% because I have 34 kilograms worth of goods in my inventory. I know if I travel to Erhen with 30-40 kilograms, I always have to pay about 2500 gold. I went to my bank and withdraw some gold, because the annoying thing about the harbor is that the fee is not deducted from your bank account. No, you have to pay the amount in cash, so you have to have the gold in your inventory. Let me select about 3000 gold. 2850 gold, yeah, that's enough. I take the gold with me now. I also destroy the branches and stones to save 15 kilograms. That means I'm now at 22 kilograms. I estimate that I have to pay about 2100 or 2200 gold to travel to Erhen. Let's ride to the harbor in the south and choose our destination there. Once you reach the harbor, look for the destination board located at the harbor. This is usually right where the harbor icon appears on the map. There's the board, click on it, and the map will appear where you can choose your destination. First of all, switch to Erhen, and you will see this lovely Erhen map. The place in the east is suggested to us. We don't want to choose that one because I said that we want to kill goblins. And the goblins we are going to hunt are right here. That means we're going to select the port to the left of it. And you see it, I have to pay 2237 gold to travel to our destination harbor. Let's travel over there, and there we are. Sniff the fresh air of Erhen and look at this new continent. Alright, let's look at the map. You see a lot of question marks on the map. Let's analyze the map. As I mentioned earlier, here's our first target, the goblins. There are also shamans running around that will give you the protection from electricity. Protection from electricity is what you need here on the left against the shock elementals. In between is an area with bandits. North in the small snowy area, you will find more goblins. There you will find shamans who will give you the protection from frost ability. That's a goal for the next episode, by the way, because you can see it already. Further north, there's snow everywhere and it's bitterly cold there. You will find even more bandits here in this area. In the far north, you will find frost elementals. That's the location where you definitely need the protection from frost, because otherwise you will be frozen by the mobs. Right in the middle of Erhen are crystal elementals. These are Erhen's newest enemy types. On the far left are fire elementals. You will need the protection from fire ability there, otherwise you'll drop dead pretty quickly when fighting them. Last but not least are the Jotuns. These are very large giants that can be roughly compared to the ogres of Mir, both in terms of damage output and the value of items they drop. So much for the map. As I said, we are going to go after the goblins first. We'll discover every single hotspot and then run in circles until we have killed enough shamans. Let's ride there. Also, collect every flower you don't know yet, because that gives 250 knowledge points each time. If you did like I did and you had destroyed all the materials for the campfire before the trip, be sure to collect 5 branches and 10 stones again, so you can set up a campfire inside the goblin camp later. You will also encounter new enemies in the wilderness, such as black bears. Kill these mobs along the way as well, as soon as you see them, simply to collect the knowledge points. Furthermore, there's a new spider. These are the small wolf spiders that jump at you. You'll get them to 100% eventually over the course of the next episodes as well. One more thing I want to note is that the wolf spider has a wonderful ability, which is this battle jump. I personally love the battle jump ability because it allows you to jump up cliffs. If you're standing in front of a cliff like I am here and you could not ride up, you could just jump up and down with the battle jump. The jump saves you an extreme amount of time because you don't have to ride all the way around to get on top of a cliff. Of course, this has the disadvantage that you'll have to say goodbye to one of your abilities to make room for it. Usually, that would be the net ability. Whether you want to use the battle jump or not is up to you. If you cannot find the entrance to the goblin area, it's worth mentioning that there are three entrances. One entrance is to the northeast, which is of course the furthest away for us. Then there's the southeast entrance. We would have taken that one if we had traveled to the port in the far south. If, on the other hand, you're coming from the west, I always ride in the direction of the tin mine and turn right to the east just before it. There you can walk through. You also have another passage right at the copper mine symbol to enter the goblin area. Once you reach the goblin area, you can simply ride in. All the goblins around here are already at 100% anyway. Only the big wolves might be missing. If you want, shoot them down. The enemies are just as strong or weak as the goblins of Myr. Make sure you have enough materials for a campfire later. Take a quick look at the map and then discover all of the hotspots. I usually walk counterclockwise, but that's just personal preference. It makes no difference in which direction you walk. At each hotspot you will find either a shaman or a warchief. These are the enemies you want to kill at the hotspot. You can already see the shaman running around. This is the shaman we came for. With that, we have discovered the Goblin Storm Shaman. Let's take a look at the Shaman's abilities. This protection from electricity, that's the goal of this episode. Now run to all the hotspots until you unlock the ability. Whether you kill more goblins left and right for the gold is up to you. I usually ignore all the goblins and ride past them until I come across another Shaman. As soon as you spot a Warchief, of course, you kill him. You most likely don't have it at 100% yet. In my case it's only 25%, so I still have to kill a lot of warchiefs. Don't miss the middle hotspot in your journey, it tends to get easily missed. You can, if you are north of the third hotspot, just ride up the cliff and shorten the distance and save some time. Of course, once you have to sit down at a campfire, you can buy new talent points right away. In my case, that's two new talent points, both of which I put into the green branch. When you arrive at the northernmost hotspot, don't be surprised if the hotspot is not discovered. At the time of recording, the hotspot was bugged and could not be unlocked. I couldn't discover the hotspot in my test runs earlier either. I ran in circles like a maniac, but no chance. The hotspot remained undetected. Nevertheless, kill the one shaman running around in the northern hotspot and take the knowledge points from him. After you've done a full round inside the goblin camp, look at your booklet and check how far you've come. In my case it's only 16%, we need to get to 40%, which means there are still a few shamans missing. Now run along the hotspots until you've unlocked the protection from electricity ability. Each shaman gives 3 to 4 percentage points. So I have to shoot at least 6 more shamans. Then, when you have obtained the protection from electricity ability, you will have completed the objective for today's episode. Let me sit down right by the campfire and let me learn the new ability. I also equipped the ability, but I won't use it yet. It's up to you now if you want to keep running in circles here to kill more warchiefs and shamans. Personally, I've had enough of goblins, I'm going to ride to the town to the south and rest there. In the next episode we will hunt the goblins in the north and unlock probably the most important ability you need on Irhen, the protection from frost ability. Everywhere in the north of Irhen it's crisp cold, there your character will freeze without the protection from frost ability. We'll take care of that in the next episode. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you liked this episode, please press the like button. And if you want to see more videos in future, subscribe to my channel. Until then, be well and take care.